Today, I want to ask one of the most controversial questions in the fierce climate debate. And that question is Elon Musk right about something? And here's the something that I'm talking about. Last week, on the 22nd of January, Musk tweeted that I'm donating $100 million towards a prize for best carbon capture technology. And of course, climate change Twitter erupted in fierce debate over whether this was a very good thing or a very bad thing. Now, I don't want to get into whether this amount is sensible, whether a prize is the best way of judging this, whether Elon Musk is the best person to judge this prize, and I certainly don't want to get into Elon Musk as a person or his other climate change comments. But I do want to discuss why carbon capture is so controversial and whether we ought to be taking a closer look at it. The first thing that you need to know is that carbon is very hard to capture. If you want some carbon to not be in the atmosphere, it's best not to put it there in the first place. At the moment, our atmosphere is filling up with carbon dioxide. We need to prioritize turning the tap off, not sucking it back out. Carbon capture is absolutely no substitute for cutting emissions, and that's why many people are understandably quite worried about emphasizing carbon capture. It seems to take the burden away from cutting fossil fuel use, even though rapidly cutting fossil fuel use is exactly what we should be doing. But here's the thing, cutting fossil fuel use is exactly what we've not been doing. The world has agreed that we need to limit global warming to 2 degrees Celsius, or ideally 1.5 degrees Celsius, to protect both people and planet. But up until the pandemic, global carbon dioxide emissions were still rising instead of falling. Researchers come up with scenarios to show how we could keep warming underneath our limits. And very many of these scenarios show that we'd need very drastic emissions cuts and some way of removing carbon dioxide at huge quantities from the atmosphere. Now, I know what you're probably thinking. Haven't you ever heard of trees? And I'd like to say that firstly, yes, I have. And secondly, that trees would really struggle to close this gap all by themselves. To stay under 1.5 degrees Celsius of global warming, we may well need billions of tons of carbon dioxide removal every year. Now, some argue that protecting and restoring natural processes could do this all by itself, but it would certainly be challenging. Okay, but what about carbon sucking up tech? Well, the most viable and the most discussed option is bioenergy with carbon capture and storage, otherwise known by the friendlier term, BECCS. Unfortunately, BECCS is something of an imaginary friend, because in the paragraph immediately after the IPCC report on 1.5 degrees of global warming pointed out that we probably need carbon dioxide removal, they state that carbon dioxide removal deployed at scale is unproven, and reliance on such technology is a major risk in the ability to limit warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius, which is a bit of a downer. And we haven't even discussed the huge ethical questions raised by dedicating huge amounts of land to these technologies, which could reduce access to important things like food and water. So let's sum up. Firstly, carbon capture is absolutely no substitute for cutting emissions, which we need to do as quickly as possible. But because we've not been doing that as quickly as possible, it looks increasingly likely that we would need some amount of carbon capture. Not instead of cutting emissions, but as well as cutting emissions. So I get why some people were angry at Elon Musk's tweet. It might suggest that carbon capture is the priority rather than cutting emissions. And I get why other people defended it, seeing as it looks like we'll likely need some form of carbon capture as well, a technology that doesn't adequately exist today. So I guess I'm saying that everybody's right. This is going to go seriously wrong in the comments, isn't it? I would like to thank all my patrons for their support, and a special thank you to Jan Galkowski. If you'd like to join them and become a Patreon patron, the link is down here. Oh, and while you're here, make sure you subscribe, like, comment, blah, 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 blah. Okay, until next time. Bye.